What's up, and welcome back to How to Play Dark Souls. This is video number 5. Today, since last time I came back here and actually rested at this bonfire, because there's something I want to do over here before continuing on toward the boss. First of all, I'm going to kill this guy. Just because I can. Freaking backstabs, man. Anyway, let's go up these stairs here. If you remember, down here there were some rats that could poison you. Anyways, come up the stairs right here, and there's a pretty strong enemy, but I want to kill him. I don't know, just cuz. You may not want to try and do this if you're new at the game, because he is pretty strong. And you can see, he does a lot of damage. But we want to get in and get backstabs on him. You see, that didn't do tons of damage to him, so... Let's see if I can hit him with some fire here. While he's stuck on the stairs. Haha, I've got him trapped. I got lucky. Whoa! Gotta be careful, though. Gotta be careful. Gotta play smart. Get around him. Backstab him. While he's on the ground, I'm gonna use some Estus. Let the stamina build back up. Let him do that attack. Whoops. Didn't get behind him squarely. Come at me, dude. Whoa. Let the... Whoa! There we go. Get around him. And you get a backstab. So when he does that big... Well, I kicked him down the stairs there. Maybe I can hit him with another fire attack. That was probably not a good idea. Okay, good. Sorry. Live commentating is much harder. Oh, that's a bad idea. Get one more. There we go. I think I got him. If not, then one more hit should do it. And just like this. So, sorry, that was probably some pretty bad commentating while I was fighting him. He has that one attack where he, like, really kind of, like, builds it up. That's the best time to just kind of, like, sneak right behind him and get a backstab. Otherwise, keep your shield out. If he's not attacking you, keep it down so that your stamina will build up really quickly. And you can beat that guy. It gives you lots of souls. All right, I'm going to meet you back at the other bonfire that I finished the last video at. I will meet you over there shortly. Okay, so we're back here at this bonfire. And we're going to continue now towards the next boss. I was talking about last time there's this big black knight in this church cathedral thing up here. And you want to approach him pretty carefully. So what I would suggest doing is getting rid of all of the enemies you possibly can in the surrounding areas first, so that you only have to deal with him and nobody else, because that can cause problems. So let's kill all of these guys first. Oh, he deked me. Eh, I'll save the fire. I'm not going to waste it on this guy. Get behind him. Get a backstab. One more over here. Get a backstab on him. Alright, now there are three enemies that I want to take care of that are inside of the building with him first. So I'm going to actually kill this guy. Like that. He's going to try and heal, but I'm like, no way. And here we go. Down over here, if you stand right at the base of these stairs, one of them will come after you immediately. That guy right there. So we'll wait for him to come out. Sneak up behind him. Oh, he deked. Try that again. There we go. Okay, so now there's one right inside the door on the left, and there's one right there as well. If you come right against the doorway and just turn left, you'll only get this guy's attention. And that's what we want. Try to get behind him for a backstab. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention. Okay, that's perfect timing. When they put their swords up like this, do not attack them. They will automatically counter you and do tons of damage. So watch out for that. When they kind of put their swords up like that, that means that they're going to try and counter you. I want to backstab you. That didn't work. Okay, there he goes. He put it up again. But this is a good time to use fire. Just because he's taking forever. Oh, just in time. This guy knows what he's doing. He's not a casual. I could try doing ripostes, but I really don't feel like it. Right now, I kind of want to reserve my reserve my Estus in case I get hit trying to get a backstab, or not a backstab, a riposte on these guys. Usually they'll just do... That was bullcrap. I should have been able to get a backstab there. There we go. Okay, once we've taken care of all three of those guys, you got this guy, this big knight to deal with. But be careful, don't fight him in that room up there, because there's a guy right up the stairs here, and he's going to be shooting magic down at you. So what I would suggest is go back around. As you can see, my stamina bar is almost as high as my health now. That's a good thing. Okay. If you look right up there, you might be able to see the guy, but I kind of just want to drag him out here first. So we can fight him out here in the open. One-on-one, we got this. Okay, he's pretty slow, so you should be able to... Actually, I'm going to try and use some fire on him. It's probably going to do a lot more damage. When he attacks, hit him with the fire. Before he can get his shield up, that'll do a lot of damage. And we should be able to get him here. There you go, it's as easy as that if you're a pyromancer. Remember how I told you to be a pyromancer? That's why. Makes the beginning of the game so much easier. Titanite shards, that's the item I just picked up. They're pretty sweet. Looks like I'm getting invaded right now. See how this thing just came up and blocked the door? That means I'm being invaded, because I'm in human form. So, anyways, I can summon this guy to try and help me fight the person who's trying to invade me. But honestly, this is the one thing about Dark Souls that is really not spectacular. The networks, they don't... Like, summoning people and invading people, like, it just doesn't work, like, probably 70% of the time. So, like, you'll be stuck here. I can't get back to my bonfire now. Kind of just stuck here waiting around for people to either get summoned or invade, and you end up having to wait for a really long time, and most of the time, it just won't work. It's kind of dumb. But I'll probably fast forward until something happens here. Unless nothing's going to happen, in which case I'll just continue forward. Okay, you want to watch out for that guy up there. He's the one that will shoot magic at you. So this part right here, it can be tough. It can be really frustrating. You have to be very careful. There's a lot of guys to fight up here, and they all have very staggered attacks. It's very difficult. It's easy. They're very weak enemies, and they're not hard to kill, but if you get caught in the middle of, like, a whole bunch of them attacking at once, you can die really, really quick. Will this guy please come down the stairs? Thank you. Come over here and fight me now. There we go. That's not what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to get backstab. Let me get behind you, please. Backstab. There you go. This guy's a little tougher. He takes a little more. There we go. While we're here, let's go up and grab this. This is a Firekeeper soul. I will talk about that in a later episode. But make sure you grab it now, because we will need it later. Here's one thing you might want to do. God, if the freaking summoning or whatever. If you go down here, this is an elevator that leads down to Firelink Shrine, which is kind of like the first area you get to after you get done with the, like, initial tutorial area in the game. Firelink Shrine is the first bonfire you come to after leaving that place, the one where the raven kind of drops you down. Anyways, that's an elevator that leads to there. You activate it here, and you can ride it back and forth, and it's a really nice little shortcut. So whoever's invading me, I would like it if you would please just hurry up and do it, because I want to do that. Okay, let's go try this out. Now, you got to be careful. You want to try and drag as many of these guys out as possible, one at a time. And you really got to watch out for this guy. He'll keep shooting soul arrows at you, and it's bullcrap. So what I want to do is grab the attention of some of these other guys and bring them back here, away from him. And I want to kill them as quickly as possible. Really Okay, that's, see? That's what I'm talking about. That can happen. Really quickly, you're almost dead. Alright, let's drag him down here and use some fire. By the way, the Black Knight that we fought, he does not respawn, and neither will... Oh, freaking. See, there's like just... There's tons of them. There's freaking tons of them. The Black Knight won't respawn, and this guy up here won't respawn. So that's nice. Once we kill them once, they are dead forever. There we go. Alright, I think this is the last guy. And then we can just go take care of him. Nope, nope, there's definitely a lot more. Come on, let's get it over with, guys. Boosh, boosh. That should be it. So that's how I suggest handling that part. And now we can just take this guy one-on-one. We got a good shield to block magic. And we should be able to take this guy out pretty easily. If we get up close, he won't be so prone to use his magic. One more hit should do it. There you go. Not bad. Okay, before going up to fight the boss, let's go up this way. Get another one of these guys up here. Just try to get behind him if we can. If we can. Back off, dude. I'm gonna hit you with fire. Oh, no, I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm gonna get a backstab, though. And then while you're getting up, right about now, there we go. Oh, he did not die. Come on. Oh, I just did the wrong... Ooh, I got lucky there. I don't know what happened, but he went into his counter pose, and I struck him. Huh. Well, that was not a perfect example of how that works, but usually when he's in that counter pose, he will kill you. Go ahead and break this thing here, because this dead body here will have a drop on him. And it's a humanity. And humanity's always nice. You can never have too much humanity in this game. Okay, we want to bust through here. Go up the stairs. And talk to this guy.
Still human, are you? Then I am in luck. Could you help me? As you can see, I am stuck without recourse.
So, we can open this with the mystery key we picked up earlier and free this guy. Talk to him. Talk to him.
Thank you. Yes. Sincerely. I am Knight Lautrec of Karim. I truly appreciate this. And I guarantee a reward. Only later.
Of course, it's always later. Anyways, we can meet up with him again at Firelink Shrine, so we'll talk to him later. Let's head down here. My game is starting to freeze up a little bit, so I'll be back in just a second. Okay, so whoever it was that was trying to invade me, he stopped trying to invade me finally, so let's continue. And hopefully no one will try to invade me again so I can show you that shortcut back to Firelink Shrine. It's a really important thing to do before you forget and continue on towards the boss. So as normal, once these guys respawn, we gotta take them out again. Just get your backstabs in. At this point, you should be starting to get pretty good at backstabs. Like, get a good feel for them, how they work. Even if you played the game a lot like me, sometimes it just doesn't work for you. I don't know why. Anyways, let's go take the shortcut back to Firelink Shrine. Right now. Just come in, stand right here. There's a little switch on the middle of the floor there. And it'll take you back. And now we can use this at any time we want to go back and forth between Firelink Shrine and here. So it's a nice, very nice little shortcut to have. And there's two sides to it. So, I mean, like, when this one goes up, this one will come down, if you know what I mean. There's an NPC here we could talk to, but I'm going to beat the boss for today, and then I will end the video, and we'll talk to NPCs next time. Okay. Now, unfortunately, all of those undead guys are going to be back to life, so I'll probably do this off-screen, but similar tactic to last time, except this time you don't have to deal with I'm being invaded again. Gosh dang it. This is why I don't like being in human form. It's not because, you know, I don't like PvP. You know, it can be pretty fun. It's just so annoying that it takes so long to get someone into your game, and it, like, closes a lot of the game off to you while you wait. Actually, I think it just happened. Guys, I just got invaded. You guys ready for this? Oh, come on. I just want to kill you so that I can fight the guy. Okay, where is he? Alright guys, you get to see how invasions work. Where's he at anyway? There he is. So he's going to attack me right away. Usually there's kind of a... Yeah, if you press select, you have a bunch of different kind of like emoticons you can do. So usually people bow to each other before they fight. Anyways, not sure what this guy's going to do, but my internet connection here is not great. What usually happens is you kind of go back and forth at each other for a while, almost like a boxing match. You know, you just kind of feint, fake around, and then somebody gets backstabbed in and it's over. He dropped something for me. What a nice guy. See, I like this, yeah, he gave me, whoa, he gave me a lot of souls. What a beast, where's he going? I want to say thank you. Well. Oh, that's freaking crazy. He just wanted to give me souls and leave. Wow, that guy is a total bro. Total bro. Anyways, let's go fight the boss now. That guy was such a bro, and you guys just witnessed it online. Alright, let's drag these guys out. I'm gonna try not to use fire on them. I think it's the last guy. Not bad. Not bad. Could have been better, but not bad. Okay, now to get to the boss, we're gonna want to go up this direction. Actually, I'm forgetting if there's anything to pick up over here. Don't want to miss anything important for you guys. There is something to pick up. Large soul, you know. Can never have enough souls. Okay, let's freaking do this. Go up the ladder here. And there's going to be a summon sign from the NPC that we met in the last episode right before the boss door. So let's go ahead and summon. Whoa. Usually there is. Where is it? Isn't it usually here? I mean, guys, I haven't played Dark Souls in, you know, quite a while, but come on, I've beaten it like 5 times. I've gotten to like new game quadruple plus or something like that. Usually I know this kind of stuff. There should be a summon sign up there for the NPC. But, you know, this will be a good opportunity to actually show something off that is kind of an important thing when you're playing the game. Okay, so I'm going to try and kill this boss on my own right now. It's been a long time since I've played the game, you know, very seriously. So I probably won't beat it on my own, but I'm going to do this anyway. If I do beat it, sick, but like, if I don't, it's going to prove my point. I'm going to show the difference between taking on this boss by yourself and then with summoning some, even just if I can get the NPC summon sign to show up, just Solaire's. But I'll also try and summon one other human player as well. And you will see just how much of a difference it makes during some of these boss fights to summon someone else to fight with you. Not only because they're going to help you deal extra damage, but because they're going to take the attention of the boss or bosses off of you. So the trick to beating this guy, if you're by yourself, if you're playing this on your own, and you don't want it, you know, any help from anyone, is to kill this gargoyle right here as fast as you possibly can. So I'm going to try and use fire. And, okay, good, I got him. You don't want to miss, like, at all. Because there's going to be another gargoyle that's going to show up. See that one? I don't know why that one didn't get off. I just missed again. Yeah, there's no chance. I'm not going to be able to kill this guy before the other gargoyle gets summoned. And the reason why it's tough is because they spam this fire attack. And it's... See, why didn't that hit? Okay, that's bullcrap. Anyway, if you kill this guy really quickly... You can see him down there at the end now. The other gargoyle is on his way over. If you can kill him quickly enough, then you can just focus on the other guy. But if they're both coming at you like this, it can be really tough because they both start spamming this fire attack. And it's just, like, endless. They don't really give you an opportunity to get close. So it looks like, yeah, see, this is what happens. You get caught in all this fire like this. So you have to really watch out for that. What would have been better is if I had run back and forth and used the space that's available to you. But now look at what happens when you summon some people. So now I've got another player with me, but I'm also, I swear to you, I freaking swear that at the top of this ladder, Solaire, the NPC, leaves a summon sign. And I don't know why it didn't show up before. Here it is now. See, this one right here. That's Solaire. So I'm going to summon the NPC. I'll have this other guy online helping me out. Watch how much quicker this is going to go. And this demonstrates how playing online can really help you in a lot of situations. Although you leave yourself up to be invaded... You know, having a couple of other players with you can make the game so much easier. By the way, if you're invaded... Oh, his tail just came off. Solaire just cut off his tail. So if you cut off the tail, you get this axe. It's a pretty good weapon. It's pretty decent if you are into heavy weapons. But what was I saying? If you've been invaded, one way to escape... invasion. Holy cow, look how fast that was. See? Look at how much easier that was by summoning people. If you're having trouble on a boss, this is what you need to do. You need to summon other players to help you. Makes the game a lot easier. Anyway, invaders can't follow you into the boss arena. So if you pass through the fog wall and come in to fight a boss, then the invaders will basically be kicked out of your world, so you won't have to worry about them. So keep that in mind, it might come in handy, especially at one particular part of the game, probably somewhere about halfway through the game. Anyways, climb up this very long ladder, and come around here outside and climb this other ladder, and what we want to do is ring this bell here at the top of the tower. There are two bells of awakening that we have to ring. This is the first of two. If I can get it to go. There we go. Okay, so there you go. We've rung the first bell of awakening. Now I'm going to go ahead and head back to Firelink Shrine. So one thing you can do is you can use this Homeward Bone, and that will take you directly back to the last bonfire you rested at. So if we use that now, we should be able to head back to the last bonfire and then make our way over to the shortcut, the elevator that will take us down to Firelink Shrine. So, that's where I'm going to stop for today. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions about anything you've seen so far, if you would like me to talk about anything specific in the next video, let me know. Alright, I'll talk to you later. Peace!